your girl, Mo Classify. We're here in Houston, Texas at Salute to the Slab with Woman Beer. We got some very special guests coming with some very classified information. So y'all stay tuned. With a very special guest, Mr. Isaiah Carey of Fox 26. But for those who don't know, I don't know why you wouldn't know, but please introduce yourself.
Isaiah Carey, Fox 26, reporter in town, also hosts the Isaiah Factor on Censor, 9 o'clock Friday nights. Always got to get a pub in.
Definitely, okay.
Working overtime.
Always working overtime. That's why we know you. That's why we can put a face to a name. But please tell us, what is the key, or maybe give us three major keys to the longevity of your success? You've been in this news industry for a very long time, and you are highly successful now, but what is the key to the longevity of it?
Well, I think I started out and I had a clear picture of what I wanted to do in the broadcast industry. I was in the third grade, and I said I wanted to be a news reporter. And so got a sort of a shadowing internship program without credit from third grade until I went away to college. But I think it's consistency, remaining true to what you want to do. And if you are covering the community, become a part of the community. Don't forget that you're not the celebrity. You're not. You're the reporter, you're the journalist who's covering, who will be covering them. And that's what I try to do.
Okay, definitely. As many, you know, being in the game as long as you have been, or being in the industry, you've had many accomplishments, you have many achievements. Is there any particular accomplishment or achievement that is still your favorite, that still puts you in awe? Like, I can't believe I received that, I can't believe I accomplished that or achieved that.
I would say for me, it was recently. I've won Emmys before, but I won broadcast Emmy for a report I did on bullying in the classroom. Some young children who were affected by bullying, and they talked about how difficult it can be for them in their day-to-day life. And they have taken that special report, which was a half an hour, and they've turned it into a teaching tool in schools. And so that made me really proud as a reporter, as a journalist who's out there covering the community, that they would consider that work a teachable tool for classrooms around the Houston Independent School District.
Yes, okay, definitely. And last but not least, since we are here at the Salute to the Slab and we're celebrating and highlighting all of Houston's artists and who has made Houston's music culture what it is, do you have a particular favorite Houston artist?
I could never say that.
No,
why? I'd be in big trouble.
Big trouble. Yeah. Can you give me a top five, maybe?
Okay, let's go with Slim, Paul Wall. Bum B, and Willie D, who's a real friend of mine. You know, you rarely get to be friends with people in the entertainment. I would say Willie D from the Ghetto Boys is a true friend. So those are my top five.
Thank you very much. You heard it here first on Mo Classified TV, Mr. Isaiah Carey. Thank you very much for interviewing with us.
No problem.
You want to give the people some extra words, some inspirational words?
Well, I just had to look up Slab. I had to Google it before I got here.
Yes.
I'm still old.
What'd you get?
Car, right?
Yes.
Colorful
yes.
Car.
Yes. All right. Salute to the Slab. Mr. Isaiah Carey, Mo Classified. It's your girl, Mo Classified. I am here with the beautiful Jess Brittany. For those who don't know, I don't know why you wouldn't know, but please introduce yourself.
I am Jess Brittany, born and raised in H-Town, Texas, queen of H-Town, queen of the South.
Definitely.
Michelle O'Brittany.
Okay, with you being the queen of the South, please tell me, you know, people want to move to Atlanta, people want to move to LA, to the big cities to pursue their dreams. Tell me the key to your success and longevity here in your hometown.
I mean, this is where I'm born and raised at, so it's always love, and everybody in Houston always supports me. But, I mean, it's nothing wrong with moving to another city and showing that your city, that other people support you too, you know, to even get that support and make it a little bit more stronger than it was at first.
Right.
Yeah.
And so with you having fans in other cities other than Houston, tell me what makes Houston like no other, musically, culturally, overall?
The city of the serve or the slow dime.
Yes.
Like, it's no other city like us. People from other states try to take our culture and do what we're doing. So, you know, why not uplift the culture and why not live the culture? Like, it's never going to go nowhere. It's always going to be around. So, you know, you live in it.
Okay.
Dropping Britney Houston on June 27th. So, y'all make sure y'all cop that. You
right.
Know what I'm saying?
That's classified information right there. Last but not least, please tell me, what should we expect from Just Britney other than, you know, what you have coming up? what's new, what's different, what are you giving us that we haven't already heard, that we haven't already, you know, seen from Just Brittany?
Well, I'm coming out with my own hairline, and it's called Bold by Brittany.
Okay.
And I'm also coming out with a makeup line, makeup kit, Just Brittany makeup kit. It'll be a liquid liner, it'll be a new eyeshadow palette, lipstick, lashes, everything, the whole 9 yards. So y'all look forward to that. I'm dropping my new project, Stripped, on April the 15th.
Okay.
And you know, that's my baby. That's something I've been working on since last year. So I'm excited to give everybody something new, a different side of Just Brittany.
Definitely.
Yes.
All right. Thank you very much. Just Brittany, Mo Classified. And we out of here, y'all.
Peace.
It's your girl, Mo Classified. I got Primes. I know this man personally. But for those who don't know, please introduce yourself.
It's your boy, Robert Primes, PT.
Okay, what else? You know, it's more than PT.
That's it. Okay. Robert Primes, PT.
Okay, so since I know this man personally, I know that he used to play football, and I know, you know, your hashtag, your main slogan is, this was not my dream. Tell the people, what was your dream originally, for those who don't know?
Football. Okay. Football is my dream. I'm 8 months in the game of doing music, and I'm blessed.
Okay, and what was the turning point in your life, or what was the decision that made you say, hey, I'm really about to take this rap game serious?
I told my ACL in 2012 at Prairie View A&M, where I graduated from. I'm an alumni. So I got a song out called I Got a Problem. It went viral. About 5-6 months, it just went viral. So I'm just blessed, man. Humble as I can say that, I'm blessed.
And would you say there was any particular formula for that song going viral?
Yeah, I got a problem, for real.
Okay.
I got a problem.
What's
but
your
you
problems?
Know,
explain them. List them out for us.
Females, money,
okay.
You know, the lifestyle, you know, it's just, it's a lot. Shout out to Go DJ IC for taking a chance on my single and putting it out there to the world. So, and shout out to Thankzilla, my PR team, so.
Okay, shout out to Thankzilla. She got me here today, too, as well. Last question. I know you have, you know, the people that are here at the Salute to the Slab event, they are legends. So with this social media age, the millennial age, what are you going to do to basically take over the game and not necessarily be temporary, but to be legendary?
I mean, basically, what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to be me. And I look at this game, I look at the music game like I look at a football game. You just keep grinding, and believe in yourself, and shit, meet me at the top.
Okay. Meet me at the top. You heard it here first. Mo Classified, Robert Primes, and we out of here. All right, it's your girl, Mo Classified. For those who don't know, everybody introduce yourselves.
C-Stone, the brand one. Dante Higgins.
Right.
Mac from Under Gravity.
And Adam Bone from Under Gravity, too.
Definitely. So we have Salute to the Slab, and we're celebrating the inspiring artists who have made Houston's music culture. What would y'all say, you know, knowing social media, knowing other music, working with other artists, what do you say makes Houston what it is culturally, musically, and overall?
Everybody that's here doing this event is what makes it. You know what I'm saying? The rec shop, the SUCs, the Swiss houses, the OG Ron C's, the Michael Watts, that's what made, you know, that's the era we come up in. That's what inspired us right here. We can't speak for everybody else, but that Texas sound is a sound that is instilled in our bloodline. Like, we love this music. That's what inspired us. That's what drives us. That's what motivates our sound that we create, and we sticking to it. We not going away. We not trying to trend produce and trend record and do what everybody else doing. We want to keep this Texas sound alive. You know, we travel all around the world. Brave on the music group Under Gravity, we travel all around the world, and people are looking for that Texas sound. They like, where's that? Because every time they come here, they hear in Cali, they hear in Atlanta, they hear, because a lot of the younger artists don't really have the knowledge on what Texas music was built on. They don't really have, they haven't done that research, they're not educated. So I really feel like documenting that Salute to the Slab concert is a nice production that will enlighten the younger generation on exactly who established the music scene in Texas. So it's definitely dope.
And then other than, you know, keeping that Houston sound and just sticking with that, what would you say is going to be the key to making you not a temporary artist, but legendary artist, you know, staying around like everybody in Houston?
But number one is getting out of Houston and taking the sound further than just the Houston area.
Yeah.
We got to go out to Atlanta. You see Atlanta people down here in Houston all the time with their music, and the media, the Instagrams, the Twitters, you know what I'm saying? What you see is, you see California, you see just not social media people. That's just not our swag. That's not what we do.
Hand in hand, I'll be trying to pull up on you. So, you know, we just got to take these great artists like Under Gravity, Dante Higgins, Breadwinner, and put it out there further than our local, because Texas so big. So Texas feel like the whole South to us. We could drive 5 hours either direction and still be in the same state. You can't do that in Louisiana or Atlanta or D.C. or Virginia. You know what I'm saying? 5 hours, you're 3 states away. So we got to just get outside of our comfort zone and really take the original Texas sound outside with us. And after that, it's a wrap. Everybody loves Texas culture, the sound. Houston, you see everybody with double cups, everybody with the grills. You know what I'm saying? They got to remember where it came from. And Dante Higgins got an album that's shedding light on how we need to grab our style back from everybody that's taking it. Get them they stuff back that we borrow. Let's get our stuff back. Y'all do y'all, we do us, and then let's just meet each other at the top.
I'm saying, we grew up on SUC music. We from the southeast area, Yellowstone, South Lund. So the screw shop was on Cullen. We used to ride our bikes right up there, get all the Rick Shop, Big Mo, Big Pokey, get them. We was able to see them face to face and shake their hands. So we grew up on their music. So we make sure we keep their music in our music. We might do it with a newer style, a new lyrical style, but we have all the old school samples, the switch up the Rick Shops and all that in the music.
Okay.
And man, it's just coming together perfect. That's why I'm here tonight. Nope D heard my music. He said, man, I like how you mix the old SUC in your music.
Right.
So I want you to speak on that tonight. So
okay, so what you're saying, the new lyrical sound, but you're still mixing the old sound. Tell me, what are you bringing different specifically? You know, what are you adding to that legendary Houston sound? But you know, something new that we can vibe to. It
really, the only thing missing from the Houston music now is the funk.
Okay.
Back in the day, they had the funky guitars and the funky sounds and the samples. So they had little Kiki numbers lyrical, but they had the funk to the music. Now the beats and stuff don't have the funk in it no more. It's the trap.
People getting away from the live instruments, getting people to come play the keys, play the guitar. And that's just an element that we're trying to change. We're trying to sit in there with musical creators, not make beats. We want to create music, and it's a difference. You know, beats get used, freestyled on, everybody do their little remix to it, and then that beat gone. But music lasts forever. They get the impact of when you hear that June 27 beat. A Houston producer didn't necessarily make that beat, but that beat lasts forever in our minds and in our ears because of what Houston did to it. Drake was able to come do that, and you jamming it, Drake going hard, but you jamming it because you playing. In our heads, we June 27, we ain't singing the Drake lyrics, you know what I'm saying? And I salute Drake for being one of the artists at the level he is to carry that Houston sound and rep Houston outside of the state. I don't have no problem with that because he paying homage and letting everybody know where he got it from. It's the artist that's taking it and not paying homage and letting them know where they got it from that I have a problem with. So all we got to do is take charge, take control of our sound, take control of our culture, and give it to them from us and not let them give it to them from them.
Last but not least, he told me you got a project coming soon. So let the world know, what should we be expecting?
Man, I got Good Forever out right now on iTunes on www.dantehiggins.com. New project coming out called Kingpin. I named it Kingpin because I'm doing poetry now, spoken word, lyrical stuff. So I just want to show people that if I pick up a pen, I'm the king with the pen. I'm the best doing it, not just for Houston, for all over. So it's called Kingpin, and it's coming together perfect. It's almost done. We're going to drop that like next month. We got Walkstar out right now, Written in Stone out, Matthew on the way, Under Gravity. Tell them about it. Now they got some funk.
Under Gravity, we got some funk. We got Space A Funk Volume 1, man. We just got that real Houston sound. It's the real Houston sound in the 2016 era. Basically, that's what it is. It's May, maybe June. It's Rec Shop, it's Jam Down, it's everything Houston time 10.
All right, that's classified information for y'all. It's more classified, and we out of here.